Pod Guy, the Thrashing Zombie. It's late at night, it's 11 o'clock, so I'm talking kind of low. Everybody's probably sleeping. It's only two other people in the house, but they're probably in bed. Well, they are in bed, or in their rooms. But I haven't done a video in a little over a week now or so. I haven't had time to do one. Everybody's been home because of the whole pandemic, and my listening place is right off the living room, so. But we also gone to bed. It's Saturday night. Figured, screw it. I wanted to get this video done. I'm a little late doing this video. 2 weeks, I think. It's actually a video for the Rock Scout. Scott, the Rock Scout, I think. He's over England, UK, somewhere. I'm not sure exactly, but he had 15 questions. Stack of records here for these questions. And one CD. So, but anyway, I hope everybody's doing good. So I'm gonna take a little drag on this. And Angel. Probably can't hear, it's not really that loud. It's on earth as it is in heaven. Anyway, a little notebook here. 15 questions. It's like a thread, I guess. Like I said, it's been like 2-3 weeks since he posted the questions, and I'm just barely getting around to it because it took me a little while to think of this stuff and figure out the answers. So, number one, name an album crying out for a reissue. This is easy for me because they had this on vinyl, but it was in 1993. I think it was 93. Yeah, 93, this album came out. Excuse me. And vinyl copies of this now are expensive as hell. Tickle on my throat. Anyway. Anthrax, The Sound of White Noise. I know some people don't really like this album. I love this album. It's more aggressive. It sounds more aggressive to me with John Bush's vocals. So, I've always loved this album. It needs a reissue. So, okay. Number two. A discography in your collection that is near completion. Anybody knows me and has watched my videos, they'll know what this is going to be, because I, as of right now, it's completed except for the last two albums that were never released on vinyl, except for the next to the last one was released, and I had it on a pre-order before everything went to shit, and it was going to be coming, I think it was this month, but Amazon said nope. We're just doing essential shit, so. Anyway, Oyster Cult. This is their first album. Self-titled. And then, Tyranny and Mutation. Secret Treaties. Spectres. Agents of Fortune, Cultosaurus Erectus, Fire of an Unknown Origin, Club Ninja, Mirrors, thanks to Billy Hurst for this. Revolution by Night, and Imaginos, and the one that I was getting was Heaven Forbid, which was just being released on vinyl for the first time. What was the name of the other one? Cursed Mirror. That was, I think I heard that was coming at some point, so I had Heaven Forbid on order, but it's not coming yet. So there's as of right now, it is done. The studio albums. Anyway, let's see. Number three. Oh, I didn't answer this one. Great cover, bad album. I don't buy albums I don't like or that I think suck. If they suck, I sell them, get rid of them. So I don't have an answer to that. Number four, bad cover, great album. Creator, Extreme Aggression. It's a great album. Terrible cover. Just considering, if you look at all their other covers, most of them are really good. And this one is just them. It's not even a good picture of them, really. And they look like badasses, I guess. But it's just bland. It's terrible. It's not their fault either. Something happened with the picture they were going to use, I read, or something. Anyway. Number five, a short album. I was going to go with Agnostic Front, Victim of Pain. It's like 15 minutes, but it's a hardcore album, so I mean, that's normal. This is 32 minutes, I believe. Around 32 minutes long. Skeleton Witch, Serpents Unleashed. Longest song in here is 4 minutes. It's 4 minutes and 3 minutes, and everything else is around two and a half minutes long. But it's fucking awesome. It's a good album. Good band. Well, it was. Let's see. A song that introduced you to a genre you love. That would be Metallica. First song I heard from this Blackened. Because the whole album actually introduced me to thrash. So, Blackened. Metallica and Justice for All. Let's see. That was number six. Number seven, an album people wouldn't expect you to like. I've shown this already once. It's Paula Abdul, Forever Your Girl. I'm not a huge pop fan or dance music or whatever this is. I do like this album. I do like most of the songs on here, only for the fact that it brings me back to not really childhood, maybe. This was like, I think when I was in high school. It was 1988, yeah. I was just starting high school. Maybe I was in 8th grade. So, this kind of brings back some good memories about when I was younger. I think she had a good voice. Let's see. Most anticipated album of 2020. I can't show you that because it's not out yet. That would be Havoc. 4, it's called. It's coming May 1st, next month. Previous albums, before this was Conformicide, before that was A Natural Selection, before that was, oh jeez, the hell was the name of that one? I'm drawing a blank. First album was Burn. Ugh, I can't remember. Anyway, Havoc, 4. It's a numeral 4 though, IV. We've got a couple songs on YouTube. One's a video, it's called Phantom Force. I can't remember the name of the other one. That one's a lyric video. Yeah, I don't remember. Both of those songs are fairly short too. 3 minutes. Which is odd for them. Anyway, on to the next question. Number nine, band artist you were late to the party with. The Obituary. So Slowly We Rot. Music on vinyl. Yeah, I wasn't listening to a whole lot of death metal back in the day. Just thrash. But listening to their back catalog, mostly streaming because I only got this album and their last one. But listening to all the other stuff streaming, such a great band. I mean, they're not like a lot of the other death metal bands. Are more slower, kind of, some points almost doom death metal. Not always, but it's got like a, their tuning is like so much heavier. It's like down-tuned quite a bit. But yeah, Obituary. I would have been listening to these all through high school. But my music taste changed when I got older, so. Okay. Album we play on a regular basis. Again, if anybody knows me, Tesla, Great Radio Controversy. I play this at least once a month, maybe twice, usually. If it's not on vinyl, it's the CD, or I stream it. I have the cassette tape, I'll play that. Cassette tape. It makes me feel good. I mean, I don't know what it is. It's just, I listen to this. If I have a bad day, it makes me feel better. You know, they got songs like Hang Tough. Hang Tough. Heaven's Tree on the Way Out. Be a Man. Making Magic. Flight to Nowhere. Paradise. Party's Over. Kind of makes me feel good. Alright. 11. A record you'd recommend that was $10 or less, or a CD that was $5 or less. See, I don't know how much this cost anywhere else. I only paid $8 for this album, and I bought it as a blind buy. I think I looked at the back and I recognized Lenny Wolf. So I said, oh, I'll try it out. It's Stone Fury's first album, Burns Like a Star. Their second one. This is good. This sound, this is just like hard rock. Good hard rock album. $8 I paid for this. It could be more somewhere else. It's like in better condition. I think Discogs said it's $13-14. But I paid $8. Let's see. The first and last in your collection. This is a two-part thing for me, too. Because I have metal and I have everything else over here. So, the metal first is Accept. Self-titled, but for the US and over in Europe, I think it was something else, I forget what it was called. The last is YNT and Rocky Trust. For other stuff, everything else is this album, which really has no name. It's put in the front. It's just a bunch of jazz or something. Pearl Bailey and Count Basie, Jimmy Rogers, I think it's jazz. I don't know, but that's first. And then ZZ Top, Afterburner. I think that's going slow. Let's see, 13, an album that changed your opinion of a band or artist. Panic at the Disco, Death of a Bachelor. Didn't really like all a lot of stuff before this album. I heard Emperor's New Clothes. I listened to the rest of the album. I like pretty much everything on here except for two songs, probably. Even though they all have the same kind of basic structure to the songs. But, interesting lyrics anyway. And two more left. Let's see. one album you'd save in a fire? Now, a lot of people would probably go like a sentimental thing for this, or, you know, one that's worth a lot of money. I'm doing one that's worth the most money, that I could sell for possibly the most money. I don't really have any albums that are super sentimental to me. Possibly that Tesla. I mean, I'd be upset if I lost any of them, but nothing I'd really worth or risk my life for. Unless I knew I could get money for this one. This is the most expensive one in my collection, according to Discogs. That's the Crow soundtrack from last year's Record Store Day. Near mint copy. $160. Is it near mint? I forget how Discogs work sometimes. Median price, I think, is around like 60 or 70, something like that. But I could probably sell it for 100 and something, maybe. I've only played it twice, so that's when I'd save it a fire. The last question is a debut album from 1986, which I assume is when Scott was born. Why else would he? Unless it's just a random year. I don't know. But I didn't think I had any from 1986 debut albums until I threw them in Discogs, and I had three. Chose this one. Cinderella's Night Songs. It says 1986. I didn't actually check this to make sure that was correct, but it was on Discogs, so I assume it was. So, Cinderella, Night Songs. And that is the 15 questions for Scott the Rock Scout. I think it's the Rock Scout. I'm gonna feel really bad if it's not, but I think it is the Rock Scout. 15 questions thread, I guess. That's it. Hopefully you guys can hear me okay. I'm not usually this quiet. I'm trying not to possibly wake anybody up and have somebody come down and ask me, hey, who you talking to? So, yeah. Next video I do is going to be the listening booth, because I haven't been getting any records, so I can't buy any records. But, okay. Rock on.